A high-level review meeting on irrigation chaired by Chief Minister K. Chandrasekhar Rao on Saturday demanded that the meeting convened by the Krishna River Management Board on July 9 be cancelled. The US government demanded a full-fledged meeting of the KRMB after July 20. It said that the full board meeting should include the issues related to Telangana state. Ministers Kokpula Ishwar and Mehmood Ali handed over Maruti Swift Zire cars to 106 beneficiaries selected under the driver-cum-owner scheme under the Minorities Finance Corporation. Minister for Minority Welfare Kokpula Ishwar said that the government has not only introduced but successfully implemented several schemes for the uplift of minorities. With no end to the stalemate between Andhra Pradesh and Telangana governments over utilization of Krishna waters, the Telangana continues to go ahead with hydel generation and was releasing water from power projects, resulting in huge quantities of water going waste into the sea. This has resulted in serious concern among the farmers of the Krishna Delta Iyakit. According to officials, 8,340 cusics of water released from Prakasham barrage in the last 2 days. Till July last year, there was 1 MMU for every 2.27 mandals in the state, covering a population of 130,136. With the addition of 539 new vehicles, every mandal will have a mobile medical unit to cover a population of 56,213. Each PHC has 2 doctors, both of whom will tour villages under their jurisdiction in turns, in the MMUs and render medical services to villages. In a setback to Chief Minister B.S. Yediyurappa, a special court for public representatives on Saturday dismissed the B report by the Lokayukt police seeking the closure of investigation against him in a 15-year-old case relating to denotification of prime land in Bengaluru. The court also directed the Lokayukt police to expedite the investigation and furnish the final or additional final report. Ravi Shankar Prasad on Saturday lauded major social media platforms such as Google, Facebook and Instagram for publishing their first compliance report on voluntary removal of offensive posts as per new IT rules, terming it a big step towards transparency. Bharat Biotech's Covaxin is overall 77.8% effective against COVID, the vaccine maker said on Saturday in a statement, citing the data from the third phase of clinical trials. The vaccine offers 65.2% protection against the rapidly emerging Delta variant, it said. It was also found to be 93.4% effective against severe symptomatic COVID-19, the company said. The world is witnessing a very dangerous period, compounded by the rapid transmission of the Delta variant, World Health Organization Director General Tedros Adhanom Ghebreyesus has warned. The WHO chief told a press briefing that the Delta variant, first identified in India, has been detected in at least 98 countries and is quickly becoming the dominant strain in many of them. A biography of Saroj Khan was being announced on Saturday, which marks the first death anniversary of the late choreographer. The film will bring to life the story of the struggle and success of Khan, widely acknowledged as India's first female choreographer. Details about the film are yet to be officially announced. World number 12, Canada's Denis Shapovalov, held his nerve to overcome two-time former champion Andy Murray of Britain, 6-4, 6-2, 6-2 in a confident showing to reach the fourth round at Wimbledon for the first time. The Canadian has been enjoying a good run on grass this season, having reached the quarterfinals in Stuttgart and his first semi-final on the surface at the Queen's Club 2 weeks ago.